Hey, I'm Todd. Thanks for choosing to watch my video. And if you would subscribe it, like it, all that stuff, you know, that'd be great. Otherwise, enjoy the video, and I hope it gives you the information you need and is helpful to you. Take care.
So I do get a lot of comments with people saying I have saved them a lot of money, and I do get questions, hey, can I send you some money somehow? And now there is a way, if you so choose, called fan funding. You'll find it on the channel page right there. 2005 Chevrolet Tahoe rear disc brake replacement. There's a 22 millimeter socket to take the lug nuts off. All bolts and nuts and everything are left to loosen, right to tighten. Jack up the vehicle, protect yourself with safety stands, take the lug nuts off, take the tire off. Using a 12 and a 16. Pull a little to get the caliper pistons to collapse, make it easier to take this off. Millimeter for the bolts holding the caliper bracket on. Check to make sure the slides are good. take these out and replace them if your brake pads come with new ones. Otherwise, you clean them up with maybe some soap and water, emery cloth, some fine sandpaper. Just clean them up. Should have your rotor machined or replaced. You can take these clips off as carefully as you want to. You could reuse them. They're just at the factory probably to hold the rotors on while it goes down the assembly line, so you don't really need them. And that is the basic removal of your brake pads and rotor on your rear disc brakes. We do want to collapse the pistons using a C-clamp or channel locks, large channel locks, like I will be doing. Or they make special tools for collapsing as well. Thing out of here. That is replacing your rear brake pads, rear brake rotor on your 2005 Chevrolet Tahoe, Chevy Tahoe, other makes and models as well. This is a very popular setup for the rear brakes, and we'll check and top off or remove brake fluid as necessary, and put the tire on, of course, and give some torque specs. 148 for the big bolts. 148, I believe, is the torque spec for the big bolts, and this is about 30 foot-pounds, 31 foot-pounds. Lug nuts are about 140 foot-pounds. So here's the brake master cylinder. Just turn the cap, take it off, put it on. It's got a maximum level and a minimum level. A little hard to see down there, so just fill it up to the max. Even before you do the brake job, you want to check your level. If it's at the max, you might want to suck some down or use a clean rag or a turkey baster or something. Suck some out. So when you collapse the pistons and push the fluid back up, it doesn't overflow. So, step on the brakes a few times to set the brake pads and such. And then top off your fluid or remove it as necessary. And take it for a test drive. Pump the brakes before you let anyone drive it. Good luck to you.